Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm Game.Film and today I'm reviewing the Korean film recently released on Netflix titled Jo Pil Ho: The Dawning Rage, aka Bad Police. That's the direct Korean to English translation. But since this is my first review, I wanted to give a quick introduction to tell you a little about me and what my channel is going to be about. As you can tell from my name, Game.Film, I will be reviewing movies and video games, along with live streaming complete playthroughs of certain games, some new, some retro. I mostly play PS4 games, but I definitely indulge in some PC, Nintendo Switch, Dreamcast, and SNES games. For example, right now, I just beat Nier Automata. I'm playing Grease for PC, Super Mario World on my Super Famicom. Mega Man X, I think the PS4, some Legacy Collection. My next live playthrough, I'm hoping to do Skies of Arcadia for Dreamcast. Really excited about that. Expect that soon. I guess you can call me a cinephile, but I'm no film scholar or filmmaker by any means. I just like to watch a lot of movies. I love Asian cinema the most, especially Hong Kong, Korean, and Japanese films. One of my favorite actors and actresses of all time is Maggie Cheung. You will hear me talk a lot about her, like a fucking lot. I love her so much. I can't say I will focus my reviews on Asian cinema, but I enjoy all types of movies. Just don't expect any musicals. I hate musicals. It's not gonna happen. But let's get back to the review. Jo Pil Ho: The Dawning Rage was made available in the USA via Netflix on May 3rd, very recently. Was directed by Lee Jong-bum. Excuse my pronunciation. He has made five films, including this one. You've probably heard of The Man from Nowhere. Very, very popular. Very good. It's an absolute classic crime thriller. If you haven't seen it, you should stop what you're doing. Watch that first before this one. I mean, this movie's good, but that's just, I mean, it's a good introduction to Korean film, and it's fucking good. Anywho, Lee Sung Quinn, Quinn plays our protagonist. He's a corrupt cop with a conscience. He doesn't like, he takes money and does some things on the side, illegally, but he's not a killer or murderer. He's not that bad. He's thrown into an absolute clusterfuck of a situation that involves our antagonist, an evil CEO named Jung Yi Wong, played by Song Yong Chang, and his psychotic fixer-upper, as I like to call him. He's played by Park Hae-jun. I won't spoil much plot-wise, but I wanted to mention this movie. Kind of reminds me of the 1985 Peter Weir Harrison Ford movie called Witness. In that film, Ford is a cop that realizes a kid is a key witness that will expose corruption in the police force, and he's got to protect him at all costs. And in this movie, Jo Pil Ho must team up with a teenage girl named Mina, played by Joan Soni. She has evidence of wrongdoings by our antagonist, and both movies I feel like have that oh shit scene, like this kid knows something, I can't just sit around, I gotta do something, I gotta protect this kid. I definitely enjoyed the four main actors' performances a lot. Jo Pil Ho is very cocky, and Lee Sung Quinn does a terrific job showing that ego of his, how he thinks he can get away with everything all the time. There's one hilarious scene, probably my favorite of the movie. It's between him and the Internal Affairs agent. Jo Pil Ho keeps saying, "Bring the evidence, get off my ass, like, pff, fuck off." And the agent has something up his sleeve, I won't say what, but it catches Joe off guard, and the look on both of their faces in this exchange is just priceless. The agent says something like, "Tiny Johnson Pil Ho, you son of a bitch, I got you." And in Korean, I'm telling you now, it just sounds so good. I couldn't stop laughing. Just gotta see it to believe it, man. I won't even try to pronounce it in Korean. It's just, I won't do it justice. But so I love the acting. The plot's very engaging. It has its thrills, some shocking deaths and moments. Kind of violent, which is what you would expect watching a Korean crime movie. I have to mention one other scene. Probably my second favorite is it's like it shows money in a puddle, and then a camera pans to a dead body of a character that just died. Then it cuts to the mouth of our villain. He's just munching, and you can hear in the audio just, and just you just really hate him. Hearing the sound is this gluttonous piece of shit. You know, you just really dislike him, and you're like, I hope this guy dies soon. So I highly recommend checking this film out if you like cop slash crime thrillers. It's a must-see. If you don't like those kind of movies, see it anyways. I promise you will be entertained. It's on Netflix. You don't have to go out to the theater, spend a bunch of money on snacks and all that crud. But yeah. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Sorry I couldn't cut screenshots or scenes from this review. I'm just getting started with this channel. I mean, I'm just using a simple Windows camera app to do this video. I mean, I promise I will get better. And my next videos won't be this raw. I've just been really anxious to get this channel going, and I don't wanna, you know, sit around. Oh, let me wait until I get this badass video production editing program so I can be real flashy. I just wanna start posting, man. I wanna get this channel going. So, give this video a like, subscribe to my channel. I greatly appreciate it. I'm also on Twitter and Twitch at game.film. Check me out there to stay updated on what I'm going to post, and I will have a schedule up on what I am. I gotta make a schedule of what I'm going to live stream. Gotta know when I'm going to do that. It's kind of hard to do with a job, and you know, my Blazers are in the playoffs too, so I gotta watch that. I'm actually kind of watching them right now. Yeah. Thanks for watching, and peace.